ABBYY FlexiCapture validation rules. We'll talk about why using rules is important, different rule usage scenarios, how rules work, rule strictness, different types of rules, and then we'll drill down and look at rules and their properties. So it's important to validate data. We want to make sure, for instance, that there's no pages missing, no data is missing, and that data integrity checks are performed. For instance, we can cross-check data between different sections of a form. And you can also modify data and perform normalization by using rules. Rules are actually executed on recognition. So right here's where they're recognized, but if a rule is executed and there's a rule violation that can't be automatically fixed and adjusted by the rule, then a verification stage is triggered. In other words, that field is marked for verification, and when a verifier comes in, they can see exactly what the rule violation is and how to fix it. So we can ensure data completeness. We can make sure that data adds up correctly, is mathematically correct. There's a lot of different checks that we can do. We can also modify field values, deleting excess data, perform normalization, and perform data merges. So some of the things we can do is a simple database check. So in this case, we want to make sure that the company tech house that we read off of our form is in our list of approved company names. And if it's not, it's going to be a rule violation. And as I mentioned, we can merge data. So here we're merging the first, middle, and last names and merging it to a field without region, a full name. So this is simply done with an out-of-the-box rule, and no scripting is needed. We'll talk more about calculate sum rule shortly, so I'll skip that for now. And again, comparison is a very powerful thing. Let's say that a name is on each page of a multi-page form. You may want to compare those names to make sure that you didn't intermix different people's forms in your batch. So we can catch that very easily. Or if there's a taxpayer ID number, some other identifying number on each page, it's a great idea to compare that data to see if there's any problems. So a rule can be out of the box, aka standard, or it can be custom written in any of six different languages. And rules can apply both to simple fields as well as complex fields such as tables. And the calculate sum rule actually will take a couple of fields or however many you point it to, and it'll add it up and put the value in a field that you designate. Maybe that's a field without region, or maybe it's an existing field that's never populated. But perhaps more valuable is the checksum rule. And the checksum rule will you tell which numbers it should add up, and then you point to the field that it should add up to. And then if there's an error, it'll be flagged. But there's a real important benefit of the checksum rule, and that is if there's low confidence characters in the handwritten fields, which is there's a good likelihood of that in some cases, but everything adds up, those low confidence characters are switched to high confidence characters. So in this case, using rules actually reduces keystrokes, and that's a real important feature and capability. We talked about comparisons and database checks already. We can do reverse database lookups as well. So for instance, we could pull in this code and put it in code 4 for manager and place it in a field without region. And merging is very, very popular. It's common for data births to capture the month, day, and year separately, and you'll perhaps get a little bit better quality, and then merge that data to a date of birth field. And once again, we've got kind of the sky is the limit with scripted rules. So you can use your own imagination and your own thinking to create very powerful rules to clean up the data or catch problems. Rules can be created at the document definition level, at the document definition section level, or the document definition field level. And usually it doesn't make a difference, except when you're dealing with table and repeating group fields, then you need to create the rule at the field level. So we talked a little bit about why rules are important, and some of the different things that you can do with both out-of-the-box rules and scripted rules. And we're exposing data errors. Sometimes we can automatically correct them. Sometimes we can reduce the amount of verification needed, as in that checksum example that I gave you. So it's important to get skillful at creating FlexiCapture rules. And again, this falls into that bucket of time that you should allocate for working in the document definition to make sure that you're getting the best possible results.